गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। सो
गुड
वेर आर द
मॉर्निंग।
होमवर्क्स? आई रिसीव्ड होमवर्क्स फ्रॉम ओनली वेरी फ्यू। अपर्णा, कार्तिक, आदित्य, ओनली थ्री फोर ऑफ देम हैव सेंड मी द होमवर्क। वेर आर द अदर्स होमवर्क्स? यस, एंड हना, यू हैव सेंड मी, एम आई राइट? यस। How about the others? And it was a similar problem, the one we discussed in the class. Only slight variations were there. Okay, please do it, complete it, and send me soon. Now, do the next problem. Let's continue. Problem number seven. Question number seven. Pankaj, Naresh, and Saurabh are partners sharing profits in the ratio 3:2:1. Naresh retired. Naresh is the one retiring. Okay. And the balance sheet is given. You can see the balance sheet. Now let's see the adjustments now. Premises have appreciated by 20%. Stock depreciated by 10%. Provision for doubtful debts was to be made 5% on debtors. So you will find out 6,000 into 5%, and that is the amount to be created now. Further, provision for legal damages has to be made. Furniture is brought up. So, prepare the revaluation account. Now, next you have given, the goodwill of the firm is given, 42,000. You will find out what is the ratio share pertaining to the retiring partner, and that is shared to him, that is given to him on the basis of gaining ratio. Now, next transaction, 26,000 from Naresh capital account to be transferred to his loan account. That means we'll prepare the capital account. We know that the balancing figure, that is the amount which is payable to this retiring partner. And the adjustment says that out of that amount, 26,000 is transferred to his loan account. That is going to his loan account. That means that is the amount kept as pending. That 26,000 will be given in installments only. Okay, on the balance, we will find the balancing figure. Out of this balancing figure, whatever it is, 26,000 will go to the loan account, and the rest of the amount, they are paying it immediately. Okay. So we need to prepare a bank account here because payment is being done. We will do the payment. New profit sharing ratio is given. New profit sharing ratio is given. That means we need to find out what the gaining ratio with the help of the formula. We'll use the formula. What is the formula for gaining ratio? Gaining ratio formula?
Minus old ratio.
Very good. New ratio minus old ratio. So start doing. There is no complication. Prepare the revaluation account first. Then I'll tell you the preparation of bank account and the later on, whatever it is. So here, goodwill is given 42,000. Okay, do the revaluation part. Revaluation account. Do it fast. Tell me the answer. Okay, those who find out the answer will tell me the answer, okay? You should tell me the answer. Revaluation account. Any doubt with the revaluation account? If yes, please ask. If you are not able to proceed, please let me know. But I don't think there is any trouble with this revaluation account preparation. Yes, you changed the 7,200 to 1,200?
No, ma'am.
No. So something somewhere trouble. Okay, let me see. We see the 7,200, it actually the amount is 1,200 in the question. Am I right? Nothing is there in the balance sheet. Oh, it's there. Oh, I'm sorry. 1,200. A provision for the legal damages is to be made for rupees. Additional 1,200 is to be made, Anjo. Okay? Okay. So we'll add it with 6,000. Thus, it becomes 7,200. Okay, Anjo? So that part is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now, coming to the next doubt, let me see. Provision for doubtful debts was to be made. Was to be made. For the, yeah, see, Karthik, we were talking. Actually, Karthik, were you helping me to correct Anjo?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Anyways, that's done. So let's move on to. Then one more thing I want to add is, sometimes in the old balance, sometimes in the old balance sheet, you might see, keep this in your mind, please take it down. In the old balance sheet, you might see this is liability, this is asset, okay? On the asset side, you might find goodwill. Yes, goodwill is there. Then advertisement suspense account. Advertisement suspense. You might find such words, suspense account. Deferred revenue expenditure. Deferred, please take it down. Deferred revenue expenditure. Okay. And also profit and loss. I hope my handwriting is okay. You can understand. Profit and loss, credit. So I'm sorry, debit. Debit, that means it's a loss. Debit. Okay, four items. Goodwill, advertisement suspense account, deferred revenue expenditure, profit and loss debtor. Only goodwill and profit and loss we usually discuss in the class. Goodwill and profit and loss, we write it off. Similarly, advertisement suspense account also and deferred revenue expenditure account. These four items, if you find it on the asset side, you will write it off. Okay? These four items. Now, coming to the liability side, you might find General reserve, that we know, we are doing it in the problems. General reserve. Then, workmen compensation reserve. Workmen compensation. Workmen compensation reserve. I told you the entry for this. Compensation reserve. And also, investment fluctuation reserve. Investment fluctuation reserve. Investment fluctuation reserve. Then profit and loss account. Profit and loss credit balance. That is a profit. So you can find 8 items here. 4 on the liability side, 4 on the asset side. Actually, these are the 8 items that we usually adjust in the capital accounts of the partners. 4 items, you understood? On the liability side, general reserve, workmen compensation reserve, investment fluctuation reserve, profit and loss, credit. Asset side, goodwill, advertisement suspense, deferred revenue expenditure, profit and loss, debit. Profit and loss debit means that is a loss. Now, let me tell you, if when you find this, you just have to, in the capital account, what you need to do is, capital account, okay? Capital account of all the 3 partners. A, B, C. A, B, C. This is how the capital account is. Okay. Whatever comes in the asset side, that you will write it off, you will bring it to the debit side. Cross. You understand? Keep this in your mind. Whatever is on the asset side, you will bring it on the debit side. Write it off. All ratio. No doubt. All ratio. Similarly, whatever comes on the liability side, you will bring it here to the credit side. Just keep this picture in your mind. X. Cross asset side, everything will come to the debit side, left hand side, liability side, whatever comes, especially these 8 terms, keep it in your mind. Workmen compensation, investment fluctuation reserve, profit and loss credit, also general reserve. That is on the liability and asset, goodwill, advertisement suspense account, deferred revenue expenditure account, profit and loss, debit balance. Is it okay? So to be on the better side, to be on the safer side, I'm telling you, suppose if you get a question, even though it is MCQ, if you are asked, deferred revenue expenditure account appearing on the asset side of the balance sheet, what do you do in the capital account? Will you debit it or credit it? Where will it appear? Okay. So please take down this. As you know, the question paper comes from the board. For MCQ, the term 1 exam question paper will be sent from the board. That is the information till now we will receive. So usually these are the 8 items that has to be adjusted. But you might have noticed in all these problems, whatever we worked out, we found only general reserve and profit and loss debit credit balance. That is only 2 that we dealt with. But in case, when you find such terms, don't get alarmed. Just do this. 8 items. How many? 8. 4 on the liability, 4 on the asset. So with this, we complete retirement. Retirement. Okay, did you take down? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, very good. All completed. Okay, now let me discuss with you. Death of a partner. Death. Death, death, death. The partner dies. So partner dies. What is the difference between retirement and death? I already mentioned See, retirement, actually the retirement take place at the end of the accounting period. Okay, accounting period. At the end of that particular accounting period, the retirement take place. So there is no much complication regarding the calculations. We usually at that it is during at the end of the accounting period that we prepare all these balance sheet, profit and loss account, all that is prepared at the end of the accounting period. So there is no confusion. But then it may take place in between anytime. We cannot predict death. So retirement, and also we can say that it is predetermined. I'm going to retire this year, or I'll be retiring next year. We know it in advance, or we plan it in advance, but death, no such planning can be done regarding the death. Talking about the accounting treatment, it is both the same. Whatever is done, whatever we learned, the accounting treatment related to the retiring partner, same will do with death also. Preparation of revaluation account, capital account, balance sheet, then gaining ratio. What else? New profit sharing ratio, goodwill, all those, general reserve, whatever we did for retiring partner, the same will apply to the death of the partner. So this is just an introduction. I just need 10 minutes time. Okay, we'll complete death on Saturday. Okay, it's time to wind up. See you on the next day. Thank you.